You have freed his holiness from his afflicted torch, the cradle of the grievous miracle, that first relic. And now, only you will be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart.
Crimson's figure and you on this side of the dream. The miracle has turned me into a sentinel of its sacred home. This is my new calling. What do you hope to find here that is not the blinding gray light that tempers our wounds and the vast horizons that extend without end? The path of paths has ended, and with it, so too has your penance. Now let your body, like mine, be bathed in blood. This will be your final resting place, but no one there is no point in recoiling from the desires of the all-knowing and all-powerful Pinnacle.
Crimson bindings.
What is this cold that is born out my entrails? Is this death of the soul? The mind? The being? My final task is completed. I will go, and so too will all those who loved me. Now I will sink down here, in this land of clouds, in this realm of dust and glimmering lights.
The Guardian has fallen. The final truth awaits you. The final outrage. Go forward now, through the embroidered mantles, towards the light.
Penitent one, who comes into our presence.
Bringing guilt to the most sacred of places, to the most forbidden of temples.
Breaking all laws, and thus desecrating His Holiness Himself. We are the High Wills. For there is no miracle that does not stem from our desire.
That is not our reflection.
That is not our word. The word that was first made flesh and then sanctified. Penitent one, does not the pale, still light of this vast horizon hurt your eyes?
Of this procession, more ancient than us, that extends out before you without end nor beginning.
Of this brotherhood of grieving souls, held captive by their own condemnation and benediction. This is the path of the ancient processions, the kingdom that the miracle wove from threads of dreams. A domain where faith would unite in one single uninterrupted act of adoration.
That would give us light and time.
That would make us eternal. And higher reaching than the sky itself. You have come to this place to atone for your sins, to put an end to this work.
Destroying our flesh that once was word, and now is but silence.
Making us cast down our eyes, leaving the miracle bereft. And so the last of our wills is your eternal condemnation. In life and in death, in hunger and in thirst, in sleep and in wakefulness.
Buried under layers of ash, the ash of your flesh, bones, and sinew.
Execrated in visage, forgotten in name, forever and ever. There is no penance that can exonerate this sin. It is the price to pay for the ultimate blasphemy.